rejoice at the sound of the organ, according to a Western saying. With a history of over 2,000 years, pipe organs are probably the most fascinating and mysterious musical instruments in the world. From the earliest hydraulis to the modern gigantic piece that's become part of this building, the special charm and sound of this instrument has captured music lovers over time, yet it's still unfamiliar to Chinese audiences. This will soon change, as in October, Shanghai has just installed the largest pipe organ in China. Pipe organs originated from panpipes. A Greek engineer in the 3rd century BC named Ctesibios placed panpipes on the water engine he'd invented, allowing people to play several pipes at the same time. Over the centuries, the first hydraulis or water organ evolved, growing bigger and bigger until finally becoming one of the most important instruments in Western music. How does this big bone giant produce sounds that are so regal? We need to get in to find out. As we blow into a panpipe to make a sound, a blower blows air into the organ. The air current goes into a reservoir to produce a steady flow, which then goes into an airtight box called the wind chest. When a key is hit, the mechanical links in the organ will open a piston to let the air into a long box called the key channel. There it finally blows into the pipes for that key. There are more than 6,000 pipes in Shanghai's new organ, providing a large spectrum of different tones.
You see very big ones who are more than 5 meters, for example. Also very small ones. The small ones make very high notes. You hear it? And the very long ones, very deep frequencies. We need lots of pipes, not only for several notes, on also for separate sound color.
The newly installed organ in Shanghai has 5 keyboards and a pedal board. However, the many keys are not the only source of its rich sound. Another key factor are the stops. Stop knobs are connected to each wooden board between the key channel and the pipes. Each of these hold boards, known as sliders, control a set of pipes of various pitches, but sharing the same tone. That's why pulling out the different stops will result in different tones, even for the same notes. Besides traditional craftsmanship, modern technology has also helped to improve the performance of the organ. Traditionally, keyboards are installed next to the pipes, but electronic technology has made it possible to get over mechanical barriers. Take the pipe organ in the Oriental Arts Centre, for example. A remote keyboard can connect the pipes and allow organists to play the instrument from afar.
它底下的控制台呢是通过数据线传输给它上面的这个控制台，控制台呢等于说控制台的后方呢有一个大型的一个就是数据的电子装置，电子装置呢会传给它本身的机子，以后它的链杆才会转动。
Another challenge faced when playing large pipe organs is the complicated stop systems. There's almost countless possibilities of different combinations of the stops. Memorizing these combinations is really a tough task, but it becomes a piece of cake with the help of computer science.
记忆卡起到的数据呢，就是说可以把每个乐手在他输入的数据上面全都存入到这卡中，使他方便于他以后的演奏。就例如说上个演奏家他在制作当中输了374这个数据，可以看到他对每个键盘当中每个音栓每组音栓当中都会有就是相应的音栓就会开启。
This is an electronic organ. It's used in the Shanghai Conservatory of Music as a replacement of a real pipe organ for training. Not only the audience, but also most of the instrumentalists in China are not actually familiar with what real organs sound like. This, along with the fact that the pipe organ is the most difficult instrument to play, has resulted in few real organists in the country.
管风琴演奏家的训练还有一个非常重要的或者也是非常难以突破的一个障碍，就是说没有乐器，因为它不像钢琴，我们音乐学院可以一下子进十几台二十几台最好的三位钢琴，我们可以花多少钱就买来，但是我们没有办法买一架管风琴，一个太贵了，一个我们没有地方去装。
它需要你一定的这个身体的协调性，因为你看到是手脚并用的嘛，还有它具有这个浮调性的这样的一个音乐的一个特征，那么就是几条旋律要同样的都一直在走，可能这是最难的。
Once known as the king of all instruments, pipe organs may still retain their glory from the past. With the new organ installed in the city,Music lovers now have the chance to listen to the sound that was once reserved for only the ears of the very privileged.
This week